So we're very happy to welcome you to Columbia University to celebrate our newest Nobel Prize winner, newest Nobel laureate, Professor Joachim Frank, Professor of Biochemistry and Molecular Physics and Biological Sciences. Our congratulations first and foremost to Professor Frank, who shares this prize with Richard Henderson of the MRC Laboratory of Molecular Biology in Cambridge, England, and Jacques Dubochet of the University of Lausanne in Switzerland. I'd also like to acknowledge Joachim's wife, Carol Saginaw, in the front, Lee Goldman, Executive Vice President and Dean of the Faculties of Health Sciences and Medicine at Columbia University Medical Center, whom I'll turn this over to in a moment, John Coatsworth, the Provost of the University, Richard Axel, University Professor at Columbia, and also a Nobel Laureate, and Marty Chalfie, 2008 Laureate, Tom Maniotis, who leads the Precision Medicine Initiative and also was the Chair of Biochemistry, Liang Tong, Chair of the Department of Biological Sciences, and all of you from the Columbia University Medical Center and the Department of Biological Sciences in Morningside who are here to celebrate this moment. From his lab in the Black Building at the Columbia University Medical Center, Professor Frank was previously the winner of the 2017 Wiley Prize and the 2014 Franklin Medal for the methods he devised to turn images taken by electron microscopes of thousands of individual molecules at different angles into a finely detailed three-dimensional representation that allows all of protein molecules of life to be seen. This is the extraordinary work that has been recognized by the Nobel Committee. Professor Frank joins more than 80 past and present Columbia faculty members and alumni over the years who have been awarded Nobel Prizes in a wide variety of disciplines from neuroscience to economics. This year's prize is a testament to the excellence of our biomedical research, which brings together faculty members from across both these medical center uptown and Morningside Heights. But today is Professor Frank's day, and we are proud to have him as our newest Columbia Nobel laureate. And let me just say, personally, this is the kind of work that usually dates back many, many years and even decades. And so it's in truth something that we share with many institutions in the world of basic research. And this is something that we take as an affirmation of what it is we do in academic work in fundamental research. A person who lives by a desire to understand something better in the world is driven to do that. And sort of selflessly pursues that to the point where new knowledge is developed that has a profound effect on humanity. So we take pride because this is a symbol of what we do, not always as well as these individuals by any means, but we strive for that. So Professor Frank, congratulations to you on this very special day. Now, and now a word from Lee Goldman. Lee.
Well, I'd like to reaffirm what President Bollinger has said, also congratulate Carol, but as you said, this is Joachim's day. It's really extraordinary and very special. He will probably tell you that at 5:18, when he was more or less awakened, he wasn't necessarily sure whether it was the Nobel Prize committee calling or the dog simply barking to be walked. But fortunately, it was the former as well as the latter. Dr. Frank has really been a pioneer in the development of cryo-electron microscopy. As you heard, a technique that provides imaging at a level that previously was not possible. But what's really remarkable about him is this combination of being a developer of a new method that allows for pictures and measurements that previously were impossible, but also the extraordinarily innovative application of that method. Initially to the ribosome, which is the cell's factory, and groundbreaking work describing how the ribosome works at a level that previously was not possible. Papers in Nature, for example, showing how the ribosome works in the a parasite that causes African sleeping sickness, and leading to ideas about how that disease could be potentially treated. Most recently, his work with other colleagues at the medical center is focused on ion channels, the little holes in the membrane through which ions traverse and send the signals and make the cells communicate and work together. Again, groundbreaking work. Dr. Frank was born in Germany during World War II, received his undergraduate degree in the University of Freiburg, spent a fair amount of time at Munich, did some work at Berkeley, and came to the U.S. About 30 years ago to join the Wadsworth Lab in Albany. And as Lee said, people have often contributed at multiple institutions. We were very fortunate to recruit Joachim here in 2008, a primary appointment in biochemistry, a secondary appointment in biological sciences, and is from his lab in the Black Building, and in collaboration with the New York Structural Biology Center, he's continued to do his groundbreaking work. Been supported by the Howard Hughes Medical Institute, by the National Institutes of Health, and also by a philanthropist, including Lynn Shostak, whose gift of the cryo-electron microscope has really helped us move this program forward. Dr. Frank has been a member of all the right societies, but in reality, today's award takes precedence over all of that. I want to thank Dr. Frank's colleagues in biochemistry who helped us recruit him here, who have helped him with his research. But again, Joachim, what you've done is truly extraordinary. Columbia University Medical Center are proud of you. We look forward not only to honoring your past work, but also knowing there's great work ahead, important questions to be answered. And this is not quite the beginning, but we know there'll be a number of extraordinary accomplishments and discoveries in your future. So on behalf of everyone at Columbia University Medical Center, congratulations.
This is an extraordinary day for me, very touching, humbling experience, because I know that so many new things are discovered all the time, and it's sort of an the shots are very the odds are very long to get me to this place, and I just really, I'm supposed to be brief in my remarks. I'm I only want to say that I wouldn't be here without the incredible support by very gifted students that I had the privilege to have with me and be able to train the postdocs and students, research associates, who all contributed pieces of this, you know, immense puzzle. And so I really like to express my appreciation to Carol, my wife, for the long and patient indulgence for my absences, you know, mental absences, which now you know how they have been spent. And I'd like to also, since as Dean Goldman was mentioning, much of the time here in America was spent at the Wadsworth Center. Wadsworth Center was a very nurturing environment, and for quite some time I was able to develop these methods. But I'd like to say that the move to Columbia was was very instrumental in me able to reach out and develop contacts and friendships with colleagues over departments, across departments. And I was also able to draw from brilliant students that I was able to recruit here. And altogether, the move to Columbia was a milestone for me, and I'm very grateful to my colleagues, faculty colleagues, to the dean and the president for making all this possible. And we are in an important transition because many people want to capitalize on this new technology, and so the support for an instrumentation center and cryo-EM facility is extremely important to make the dreams of many of the people here come true, and there has been a wonderful support. And there were generous gifts that have made possible the acquisition of new instrumentation. So thanks very much all around. Was a very confusing experience, you know, because we mentioned this dog, and we've been anxious every morning because it's been waking up earlier and earlier, and today I was sure it's going to be woken up by the dog, but instead this phone call arrived, and then when the phone rang, I wanted to actually be sure that Carol didn't dismiss it as a crank call, because I knew the sensitivity of the date. So sure enough, there was a Swedish accent, and then everything that followed. So it was amazing, and all I could say over and over again, this is wonderful news. I didn't know anything else to say to these people in Sweden, and they kept apologizing for waking me up so early.
Any other questions from press? For the students and fellow faculty members who are here, there'll be time to chat afterwards. Anyone else on the line or no? If not, we'd be glad to wrap it up. Professor Bollinger, Dr. Bollinger, thank you so much.
Thank you.